Please write down a dictation of transcription number 178 from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. Sir, the present pattern obtaining in the educational system of our country is like this. First of all, there is what is called the pre-primary stage or the nursery school. Then comes the primary stage, and then comes the higher elementary schools, and then the 3 years education in the higher secondary schools. This higher secondary system has been formed by the addition of 1 year to the high school system, or by taking away 1 year from the intermediate side and adding it to this side. The university course took 4 years, 2 years for the intermediate and 2 years for the degree course. Out of this, 1 year of the intermediate course was taken away and added to the higher secondary system. This is the system that came into existence. The higher secondary system reduces the university course to 3 years, and the intermediate course is abolished. The intermediate colleges, as they were called, were converted into pre-university course colleges. This pre-university course comes after the student has passed the 3 year higher secondary course. This is the system obtaining now. Now let us see the objects of this resolution. This change has brought in its wake certain defects and disadvantages. Let me point out these disadvantages. Either in the pre-university system or in the higher secondary system. Talking of the higher secondary system, I would like to say that certain schools were amply upgraded to higher secondary schools by tagging on 1 year of the university course to the existing course. There arose the question of equipment necessary for such a course, which may not have been there in many of the schools. I know of a number of schools which were unfit to teach the university course of 1 year, but still sanctions have been given for converting the secondary schools into higher secondary. There has not been sufficient equipment, especially for science laboratories, etc., nor have there been enough of teachers capable of teaching the 1 year university course. This, according to me, is a very great and serious disadvantage, especially to the boys coming from the rural areas who have not had sufficient grounding in the various stages of their school education. The higher secondary or the pre-university course is a gateway. Unless he crosses that, he cannot go over to any technical course or to the university. Madam, what I feel is that there is a sudden rise in standard, whether it be the pre-university stage or the higher secondary stage. In this stage, suddenly pupils are asked to give essay type of answers, whereas in the secondary school stage, it is only filling up of the gaps or words or phrases are to be given for a proper pass. And this is all compressed in 1 year. There is an enormous stepping up so far as the subjects are concerned. And on top of it, the whole thing has been compressed into 1 year. It may be all right, madam, for students coming from the educated classes or the upper urban classes where the grounding has been quite good. Not only they are educated in school, their knowledge is further supplemented by the tutorial system, by parents and others in the house. So even if the course is compressed into 1 year, they can probably follow, they can manage. But the students coming from the rural areas who have no grounding whatsoever find it extraordinarily difficult to cope up with this pre-university or the higher secondary system of education. I can also show by figures how awful wastage has been there in this pre-university system. The duration of courses of only 180 days is insufficient to enable him to assimilate whatever is taught to him. Even lectures, he is not able to absorb and assimilate. After all, if education is not absorbed and assimilated, it serves no purpose. It is a different thing that he gets a pass, but subsequently, in life, in technical courses, he finds a lot of difficulty. Madam, I happen to be in charge of a certain hostel where students seeking university education from the rural areas have been given a dominant place where free feeding is done. The hostel is situated in Bangalore city, and we find that not even 1% pass out completely in any year ever since this pre-university course has been introduced. I think it was introduced in 1956-57. Ever since that time, the students have been finding it difficult to pass. Madam, I have been managing this hostel since 1940. In the intermediate system, somehow, because it was a 2-year period, they slowly and steadily learned something, absorbed and assimilated something. In the intermediate system, there was a possibility for the science students to conduct experiments, but in the pre-university stage, no chance seems to be given to the students to conduct experiments either in physics or chemistry. Stop.